The FDA is a very strange organization that has a history of not making science-based, rational-based decisions about its approvals. This was started in most noticeably in 1987 when people with AIDS in New York City were dying of what is called pneumocystis pneumonia, PCP. And the clinical experience then had been amassed of a large number of cases who were prevented from dying by use of the antibiotic Bactrim. This is, even then, was a generic medication and cheap. And activists obtained a meeting with Dr. Fauci and 15 of his selected scientists at FDA, at NIH, and asked Dr. Fauci just to make guidelines to physicians that they consider using Bactrim to treat preventively AIDS people so that they wouldn't die of this pneumonia. Dr. Fauci refused. He said, "I want randomized, controlled, blinded, controlled trial evidence. That's my gold standard, that or nothing." The activists left. The NIH did not fund any randomized trials. They raised money themselves from their own AIDS patients to collect the data to do a randomized trial. It took them 2 years. They came back to Dr. Fauci. During those 2 years, the FDA approved AZT as a treatment for AIDS. AZT works, but not completely. It needs other medications as well. And during the 2 years that it took them to get this data to come back to Dr. Fauci to support using Bactrim, 17,000 people with AIDS died because of Dr. Fauci's insistence on not allowing even a statement supporting consideration of the use. This has gone on before. Now we have Dr. Fauci denying that any evidence exists of benefit, and that's pervaded the FDA. The FDA has relied on Dr. Fauci and his NIH advisory groups to make a statement saying that there is no benefit of using hydroxychloroquine in outpatients. And this is counter to the facts of the case. The evidence is overwhelming. The FDA has also said that there's the harm of using these medications in outpatients outweighs the benefit. And in fact, they said this with no effort, information, no evidence whatsoever of any harm in outpatient use. And this is provable both on, by the fact that the FDA's webpage says has a warning against outpatient use, but says it relies on inpatient hospital data, which means they don't have any outpatient data, as well as the fact that 90% of the cases of COVID this year have occurred since the time that the FDA restricted usage to inpatients only. So the FDA knows that it has no data for outpatients and no data on harm, and yet it denied the Henry Ford petition for outpatient usage. Dr. Fauci and the FDA are doing the same thing that was done in 1987, and that's led to the deaths of hundreds of thousands of Americans who could have been saved by usage of this drug. And this is the same thing that the FDA has done. It's outrageous. People need to be writing or calling their congressmen and senators and complaining that this is not the way the country should work, that a bureaucracy that's in bed with other forces that are causing them to make decisions that are not based on the science, that is killing Americans, is not acceptable.
Well, at a minimum, they ought to be reaching out to experts like you and experts all over the country who have something to contribute to this. I mean, after all, it's a pandemic, and constantly going on TV and telling everybody to wear a mask over and over and over again and social distancing, that doesn't sound very scientific to me. I want to thank you, Dr. Risch, for your courage, for your insight, for publishing what you're publishing. I know that it can't be easy.